All right, then, that spectator delay is counting down. Let's turn that music off. Helena's just telling me about something interesting that happened on Paladin's stream on the Chinese one. Apparently, Happy Happy is infamous for his walls, and Happy was asking Paladin to take it easy on him and not take the mick out of him for all of those walls. And, of course, the upcoming map apparently is Islands, or Team Islands, one of the two, and Helene asked Happy Happy how he was planning on walling in this game, and his response was that Happy will wall along the shoreline so that his enemies can't land. So let's see if he does that. I remember seeing that one. I don't remember if it was a pro game or not, but it was pretty infamous when it happened. I think it was on a Team Islands game or something. I think Tim has walled the shoreline before. I'm pretty sure of it. But yeah, it's going to be Islands here, not Team Islands, as some were suggesting in the chat. So let's quickly scan over players and civilizations here. And all four players are the same here, although the colours seem to have changed. Actually, they're not, are they? IMOK is in, so let's start with him, wherever he is. Yeah, IMOK is in. That's his main name, I think. Will be familiar to people who've watched quite a lot of AOC in the past few years. Who's gone out then? It's Miss Yu, isn't it? And that's interesting because I thought Miss Yu typically played the water maps for NC. Maybe someone in the chat will correct me on that. I think, no, maybe it was number 23 that came in for that. I don't know. But interesting, I thought they'd be in. But anyway, I'm okay playing Saracens as blue. He is in the pocket position. The Chinese team has Happy Happy in green on the flank. So let's see if those walls come up for him. That's Japanese flank. That's kind of unfortunate. Japanese in the pocket is really nice on islands to kind of abuse the fish boom. Normally on islands, you'll see at least one pocket fish booming and going with a faster castle time. It's always nice if that's Japanese because it's the fishing ships are just that bit better and that little bit more durable. Although not uncommon to want to see the Viking player going with that more FC approach as well. Then on the opposite side for the Chinese team, we've got Tim, Panda TV. That's the name of his stream title. He's in the yellow colour as Viking, so kind of being elected by his team as the strongest player here, which is fair enough. Although I don't know if he's as far ahead of his teammates on water as he is on standard Arabia and such like. Seems we've got a bit of a pause here, so that will give us some time to continue looking at the rest of the players without missing much of what's going on. Vivi's playing right flank as Huns, so Saracens, Vikings, Japanese, Huns, perfectly standard line up here. Don't think this is a re, as the host time's gone past 4 minutes, hasn't it? But it's only a short one. Okay, here we go. Remy playing Japanese flank. So the same thing for the Polish team. Not got the Japanese in the pocket. But they do have a Viking pocket in the form of Bals, playing in the purple colour. So both teams with Viking pocket. That's quite nice. Interesting though, we have Persians for Jamjack. Now Persians are a pretty good water sieve. The TC and dark work rates. Of course, you get a nice Dark Age with the extra resources. But I think, are they lacking Bracer in the Imperial Age? I'm going to have to check that. Because my memory of that is a little sketchy. Yeah, Persians lacking Bracer in the Imperial Age. So if we get to the Imperial Age, the Galleons aren't going to be quite as strong for Jamjack there. It's funny though, because last time I saw him play on water, he played Master of Islands against Bullet Chen and he won the game with Elite War Elephants with a little bit of a kind of troll tactic / just having a bit of fun with his opponent after he'd already got a decisive advantage. I doubt we'll see Elite War Elephants for Jamjack in this particular game. Jamjack will probably be wanting to see this be cleaned up and done in the late Castle Age, because his Galleons will be weaker in the Imperial Age perhaps. This is a very aggressive looking lineup for the Polish team here, and they haven't got a Saracens player either, and the Saracens can really come through as the strongest navy by the late game because of that fire speed. And then rounding out for the Poland team, we've got Kimura on the flank and Teal playing as the Huns. And villager going down for Jamjack. First of all, luring with the villager and not the scout, but he really didn't get far at all. And this boar's going to come in very late. And it's getting blocked some more, and it might go back now. It may still go back. No, it won't. I thought it might get hung up on that villager in the tree for a little bit longer. But messy, messy Dark Age for Jamjack. Oh, he's blocked the villager again. Two villagers down. No loom. Two villagers down. Boar in at 6:30 and not under the TC. Disastrous start by him. It's a good job that he's not flank is all I can say. Else he'd be in a huge mess now. But as Persians, he should be able to catch up on this, at least. But he's only down to 17 vills. I see blue is on the same population. I wonder if he lost a vill somewhere. No deaths for him. Actually, no deaths for anybody else. So he had a bit of idle for some reason. Yeah, I'm not sure why blue got slowed down to that extent. Baal's doing a loom, so is he going to be on his way up soon? In fact, we should see the flanks going up really in the next kind of 20 seconds or so. Let's have a look at dot positions. Happy, happy as the Japanese. Just trying to get a little bit more out of those Japanese fishing ships by keeping them towards the back. Remy playing Japanese is also back docked on his island. And the way that Orange's island, Remy's island, looks, he could almost play this like a pocket and rely on Jamjack to act like the flank for him. Except if they do that, then Jamjack is very far behind. I say that because this island just extends way down here towards the middle of the map, so it'd take ages for the enemy galleys to get behind Remy's island, and so Jamjack could just come down the flank here with his galleys. But with the Dark Age that Jamjack had, he really can't do it like that. But he's on his way now, and he's actually not last up to the Feudal Age. He's going up at the same time as Remy. But a little bit ahead of Remy, but Remy going up with basically the same population, having not been down two villages, so I don't think he's had the best Dark Age here. Poland, as far as I can tell, not really making the most of their home map with their Dark Ages here. Remy's flaring out that island. Seems he hadn't communicated that freaky island, as someone says in the chat, to his team just yet. So any kind of strategy that they could have formulated based on that island, they haven't. They haven't formulated a strategy based on the island shape is what I'm trying to say. Like that thing I was talking about with Jamjack potentially acting as a flank from the pocket and them swapping over. I'm not going to see anything like that. But this is a difficult island for Remy. If they lose the water superiority, which I think there's a good chance of it because they've had such a bad start on the right hand side, everything for Remy's by the water. Look at this. Both golds in range. That will certainly be in range by the kind of Castle Age with Bracer and War Galley. All the wood lines close to the shore, and then because all of the land is kind of out here, even that's extra wood lines way out towards the middle of the map, practically on the pockets island for the enemy team. So messed up. I guess it's this forward where the game decided to put this extra resource island has really interfered with the Remy's island generation. But it's not bugged, it's just unusual. No case for claiming a bug map, just something you have to deal with. Adapt your strategy. Of course, if he'd scouted his island early enough and he really didn't like it or something, then teams have opportunities for restarts. And if Jamjack had lost his two villagers at minute 3.5 instead of 6 to the first boar or something, then maybe Remy might have got a better generation if they'd chosen to restart for that reason. Anyway, first galley's out on the left hand side. Happy's gone flying past Barbs, his forward galley. These will come together on the left-hand side. That's Kimu and Happy. Happy is not on patrol, is he? He's just right-clicked and he's taking a bunch of fire as he just goes straight past Kimu's galleys. We'll try and head up here towards the fishing ships, but there's plenty in defense here for Poland. Lots of galleys for barbs. The fishing ships are nicely out of the way. And Kimu is on 6, actually. But that's actually the least on his team. You look at the Polish team in general, they're on 7-7-6-4. Then the Chinese team has I Am Okay. Just mega fish booming in the pocket of Saracens. 16 fish already. That's insane. He's obviously going with the more fast casting approach. Market coming up, and he'll be kicking up at around 14 and a half minutes probably if he's got the resources, which I'd be surprised if he doesn't with that many fishing ships. Right hand side then, let's see if the Polish right flankers managed to hold firm with the terrible start that they had. Jamjak is really being overwhelmed by Vivi in the red colour, Sobidiao. That's double galleys for Vivi. Just 1-0. But the important thing is that the Polish players can't stand against Vivi at the moment. Not until at least Remy doubles up and Vivi will go back. But that makes sure that the Polish players are not getting anywhere near the Chinese harbours, and the Chinese fishing ships will remain protected. Whose Barl's probably lost a fish or two. We see that Happy's on 3 kills and maybe he got a couple of fishing ships rather than galleys there. But for the most part, I think Happy after kind of going to the docks of Teal and Purple is probably going to play this quite defensive from then on, because his role as the flank here is really to protect that fish boom that his pocket has. He's only doing a few guys. He's on the way to the Castle Age. They won't want to lose those fishing ships too early. And he'll just wait for his pocket to get into the Castle Age and come and support him. 28 galleys in total for Poland on the right hand side, so they're getting on to a good number now. Between red and yellow, that's Tim and Vivi, they're only on 27 as well, so pretty even actually. After the bad start, they seem to have kind of turned that around, but the problem is that Tim has gone up to the Castle Age with war galley done, Bodkin arrow kicking in, and the Polish team will not want to take this fight. They may have had one or two more galleys in there to start with, but Tim getting the war galley really turns that around. And Tim, 2-0. Not a big deal, not terrible losses there for Poland as they retreat. But they'll have to keep on retreating just until they get a player into the Castle Age. Probably another pause here. Blue is in Castle Age as well. War galley 20% done. Bodkin almost done. I guess at this point can have a look at some of the players that are in Feudal Age, see how far any of them are away from making it up. Vivi should probably be clicking up in about 1 minute. Happy on the flank, quite a bit further away. Look at that, 350 food. Barls is on his way, about a third done, a quarter done-ish. Kimu in the teal is sort of close, a little bit further away than Vivi was, but it shouldn't be much more than a minute. Okay, the game's running. Let's go back to the fight that we're looking at down here, because this is a lot of stuff in the mix. Barl's galley's not really doing too much there. The fishing ships were going by, but they were just missing all their shots, so that the Chinese team were getting some free hits in. And now Barl doesn't want to stand there too much longer. Yep, Poland in full retreat, although they should be able to pick some fishing ships on their way out at least, because not really too sure what Green's fishing ships are doing here. Kind of coming forward with quite a lot more in the rear there. That's about 36 galleys in this position for Poland versus about 25 for blue and green on the Chinese team, so big numbers advantage on the left-hand side for Poland, but not a technological one. Right-hand side, large navy for the Polish team again, but that war galley upgrade really being decisive over here. They can't take this fight, they're going to continue to give up ground, and the Polish team could end up losing a dock or two whilst they wait for those upgrades to kick in. Both Remy and Jamjack are on the way to Castle Age now, almost exactly the same times. They do have about 40 galleys there. But the same for Tim and Vivi, actually. 43. Still, defender's advantage is there for Poland if they're going to take this fight. They'll have the reinforcements coming in from close. And despite War Galley being in the mix with Tim, seems like Poland are doing an okay job of this. But seven more War Galleys reinforcing for Tim could really make the difference. Hard to tell as both players maneuver their fleets trading blows. Just looking at the kills to deaths, the Polish team here has traded fairly evenly thus far. And I think once those upgrades kick in for them, they should do okay here. Jamjack's Persians will really start accelerating in the Castle Age, making up for any early game deficit that he had. But on the left-hand side, blue and green for the Chinese team are right in the Polish waters. Seems Kimu went completely back. Bars does still have a lot of war galleys forward, but he's not going to be able to do too much damage here except to some of the fishing ships, which Happy Happy is peeling away, and which they do have some defense for down here. And meanwhile, that's going to leave Kimu fighting basically alone against both fleets of the Chinese team here. Biles has some here, about 8 galleys now, but not huge amounts. That said, they'll have a fighting chance of getting rid of this because the war galleys still a way off for Happy Happy as he hasn't hit Castle Age yet. And Kimu is well on the way to those upgrades. So they're going to defend that area. It seems Kimu. No, he hasn't lost his fish. He's managed to relocate them. That's nice, but only to shorefish. As Bar's doing down here with that forward fleet that he has, seemingly repelled quite nicely by IMOK Saracen Navy there. But just looking at the numbers of military in the game, everyone for the Chinese team is on around 15, some closer to 20. So I'd say no more than 70 ships there. Just quickly scanning that. Not quite taking the time to edit all of it individually, but for the Polish team seems like they might have around 20 galleys more in total. So a bit of a superiority on the water now in terms of numbers, and villages and fishing ships largely the same for both teams, the only outstanding thing being the fact that IMOK does have a lot more. But we see a transport out for Vivi, barely spotting that, hiding in amongst those galleys. I'm going to switch to his point of view, see if there's anything in it. Because this island, obviously, for Remy is such a vulnerability. Nothing in the transport. But, you know, Vivi can land, or Tim could land anywhere on Remy's island here. And I actually quite like what he's doing, building up so much stuff at the far end of it, because it decreases his vulnerability to landings on that sort of weirdly stretched island. Gives him a lot more line of sight. No places for the enemy team to hide if they choose to land. This is a menacing fleet from Kimu. 38 war galleys, and he could take down a TC here if he wants to. Happy Happy with only 25 in defense here, and some of them. No, they're just fishing ships, okay? Kimu could take this fight, but it's about getting a nice patrol, because the issue with going in here, some of his galleys would shoot at the docks, some would shoot at houses, and, you know, the fight might not go so well for him unless he's keeping an eye on what his galleys are actually doing. But Bars is coming in here from the northwest now. This is going to be a fantastic trap if they can manage to spring it. Poland need Kimu to really get up here and make sure he's firing down on those. I feel like Bars and Kimu, with just a tiny bit better communication positioning there. They could have had Barls here, Kimu really pushing on down the channel and trapped that army and just that navy and really destroyed it there. Kind of unfortunate for them. So nearly a very, very good move. Once again, a bit of a pause. I wonder if we've got lag here. Such a tight game, to be honest. Look at the scores. 16 points difference between the team scores. So after a rocky start, Poland are well into this game. And like I say, they seem to have, or they did have last time I counted it, they seem to have more numbers on the water, although Chinese players are starting to mass up a bit better as well. Last time we looked, they were all on kind of 15 or 20. Everyone's on similar numbers of villages as well. It's basically three players on 50 for each team and one player on 40. And those just so happen to be opposite flanks for each team. Left flank for China, Chinese team a little bit behind. Right flank for the Polish team a little bit behind in village account. So superbly even game developing here. And I hadn't spotted this because of the orange and the red being quite similar, but Vivi has landed. We did see that transport for him, but nothing was in it. But he's been picked up by Remy. That's not going to get anywhere. He's walled a villain, but really nothing much will happen with that landing. It's unsuccessful. One vill being chased. And that vill is even being hit through the diagonal of the wall. So try and move it away. Vivi has gone to send it to chop the tree, but Cavalry are just coming out. If Remy doesn't start putting down something here to deal with this, then a couple of cavalry archers could be a nuisance. They shouldn't be able to achieve anything much other than nuisance value, but it's something, isn't it? Unfortunately for the Chinese team, they might fall prey to the galleys from the shore as Remy and Jamjack bring back 20 or 30 ships to shoot at one cavalry archer. Left hand side, just there. Congestion here of so many galleys just grouped up in one spot playing defensively. Kind of the same up here as Kimu and Barls, Normanganda. Just lay a bit of siege to Kimu's island. Stream ended. Okay, let's just check the lobby. Yeah, all the players are back, so let's go back to the lobby. Some communication going on in Chinese here with Lix saying what Happy Happy was saying. I will have to maybe wait for some confirmation from Helene to understand what's going on. I assume they just wanted to fix lag or something. It did seem like a very laggy game. Let's throw that music on just while we wait to figure out what's going on. Okay, they are launching again, so nothing more than a brief delay here. I assume we're going for restore. Yeah, we are indeed. Restore. Thank you. Right, their spectator delay is counting down, so we'll be in the game in less than a minute now. Someone says, what we're going to see here? We're going to see Age of Empires 2 in a $30,000 team game tournament sponsored by the Chinese community. Currently playing on Poland's home map, which is islands, very water focused map. And we are reshoring in the middle of a game. Because the players saved it and are now reloading it. And that piece of music ends just in time. Alright, everything loading back in. I hope... I don't seem to have any researchers here. I hope my overlay is going to be working, because I swear there were... Okay. I want to go to the I'm okay and see if he's up. Yeah, he's on the... So, okay, so pre-existing researchers that were happening when the game was reloaded aren't showing up on the overlay, but I'm okay is up. Tim... Was Tim up as well? No, not yet. It's actually a long way away. So it's probably going to be just Blue who's up. Seems like the game's suffering some lag as it restarts here. Try and get it to run at normal speed. Huge battle coming together here. It seems to me that Barls was a bit out of position. He does have some galleys in there, but the Polish team, that was a bad, bad engagement for them. The patrol was just so much better for the Chinese team. They had all their players, sorry, all their galleys just stacked up so nicely in a row. Really good patrol for them. And that engagement was bad for the Polish team. Let's have a look in the middle where we see a gigantic number of galleys. The team just destroying a dock. Not too pivotal, obviously, but just that yellow mass on the minimap just looks frightening. Vivi blundering into Jamjack. Barnes is on the way to the Imperial Age for the Polish team, so he'll be able to combat the Pocket, who is up for the Chinese team. That's the blue player. But once we get into the Imperial Age, you know, the Saracens really do start to shine at that point. And although Viking Pocket, their bonuses pay off throughout the game as well. And the Viking Pocket's tremendously strong. It's hard to go up just against a Saracen galley. Just sort of galley for galley. And Jamjack's up as well. That's good for the Polish team. I just want to... Yeah, Tim's up too. That was weird. When I switched to his point of view initially, it wasn't showing him advancing there, but it also wasn't showing him advancing here. But he is up, actually. So both pockets for the Chinese teams are up, and therefore it's a good job from the Polish point of view that Jamjack's on his way. How is Vivi doing? Vivi's 50 food. Okay, so he's not going anytime soon, although he's got enough resources of other kinds in the banks to use the market a little bit and try and get up. How's Remy doing? Remy's in a much better spot. The landing for Vivi, a few cavalry archers have come out, but there's been no damage, has there, really? There's a mangonel out, TC's, Siege Workshop. Remy's absolutely fine there. Let's check the water as those some of those upgrades are going to be coming in. Barl's getting Bracer. Kaimu 50%, Imperial Korean kicking in. Huge navy here, there's no hope of punching into that. As the Chinese, especially not alone if you're I'm okay. But nonetheless, those are Saracen galleons with Bracer, so you want to make sure if you're going to engage them now before you get all your upgrades in, you've got to get a good fight. There's no point having like 20 galleys versus 20 on the front and 50 on the back. And it seems that Poland would rather just retreat and get all the upgrades in. Happy Happy is miles away, isn't he? Like 2,000 gold, no food. And now they are going to take the big engagement here. And with Happy Happy retreating out of there, that makes 2v1 against I'm OK. And even if I'm OK does have Saracen galleons, Barls has galleon and Bracer done. And there's just so many more numbers there for Poland. Kind of bad by IMRK to linger there, I feel. And we have three Imperial Age players versus two in favour of Poland right now. And as we looked before, I think the fourth player, Remy, was closer to the Imperial Age than the Chinese fourth player. But now we're seeing how bad Remy's island is. Timmy is here with 90 galleys. That's insane. Vikings. Wow. And he can destroy town centres in a matter of seconds. And Remy's about to lose 10 villages instantly if those galleons don't focus on Jamjack's ships. Nice patrol there for Jamjack, I think. He's got like a higher percentage of his galleons in the fray there. A nice line, but Tim sorted his patrol out now. And Tim has so many ships there. Jamjack, you don't want to linger around there, son, I don't think. You really don't have the numbers. And Tim is just demolishing those galleons as they try and turn tail. And look at this, another 30 or so coming up behind. Gigantic fleet. He's still on 86. But he needs to be. I mean, look at the military numbers for some of the other players on his team. It's really low. Then again, Poland do have one player on 17 as well, and that is the guy over here. So Tim, with just such local superiority, he could really push down the right-hand side and almost win the game on his own down there if he's really aggressive with it. Vivi's on the way to the Imperial Age, so it seems Vivi abused the market to get up, and probably happy too, I would have thought. So they're both on the way, and Remy is still languishing in the Castle Age. 15 military, only 52 villages, only 80 food, not really getting involved in the fight, and having his island besieged from all directions by this just menacing fleet that Tim has. And Vivi on the front lane waste as well. This island for Remy is just terrible, and it's working against him so much. And now Vivi's landed with a stable and a siege workshop, and I think he'll be able to do more damage with that. He's even stonewalled it off so he can concentrate on trying to wipe out one half of Remy's island at a time. Admittedly, there's not a lot here, but still some good damage. And to be honest, you could house the hell out of Remy with killing all of the, destroying all of those houses. So I think Remy is in danger of really becoming a non-factor in this game, and it going down to 3 versus 4. Pretty big engagement up here with both navies on good patrols. Hard to tell who's getting the better of it. I think it might have been IMRK just about there, but quite a lot of reinforcements coming in for the Polish team. But what are they doing? They're not on patrol, are they? Let's quickly check elsewhere. Tim is really helping out the other side as well. Kaimu is going to get trapped there. Happy Happy's there. Tim is there. Some from Barls too, but that's a lot of losses for Poland to sustain here. But at least they've won this fight up here from their point of view. And Barls is down here with quite a lot, destroying the reinforcements for IMRK as they pop out. But even so, the Chinese team could trap that if they brought all of this down there. But Tim's going back to the other side now to group up with Vivi. And but look at this, like, we're looking down here and thinking, wow, Tim's got a lot of galleys, hasn't he? Yeah. And then we go up here and it's like, just what? How can you have so many? 86 still. And Barls is about to lose a lot of vills. Unfortunately for him, that main gold is so exposed from the shoreline, along with some of his wood lines as well. Tim is playing like a monster here. I want to scroll the overlay, see if he's got any sling at all. But I think it's just all under his own steam. Vikings pocket. He's playing that to a T. Not received any sling. Just playing like a monster. Transport coming out for Poland though. 5 vills there. Wonder if we'll see those trying to land on Happy Happy's island, or perhaps trying to take the extra resource islands, as Tim still prowls around the edge of Barls' island, and as Remy just continues to suffer really. Red is all around him, destroying him. What have you got 10 monks in there for, Remy? Why? We gotta land 10 monks? Convert all the ships? I don't know. But that's 1,000 gold down the drain. And Remy's down to 50 population, and it's going to be dropping more and more. All those buildings will get cleaned up too, and I wouldn't be surprised if... Okay, Vivi may not be able to land on the front of Remy's Island just yet. There is a castle there, and a nice spot. Yeah, just reiterating, Vivi's red, Tim is yellow. Okay, Bars has chosen to land the middle island. These are nice strategic castles in the kind of intersection of some of the channels here. He's also going to secure extra wood and lots of extra stone, which will allow him to build... Okay, it's just one castle actually in a siege workshop. Some siege rams on the shore could really help actually. Siege rams from the Viking player, but what's Tim doing? Looks like the Polish players are going to try and trap him here. There's a lot of galleys coming from Bars. A handful coming from... Jamjack, but the rest are in the open water, not really helping out. And Tim's just got so many here, Bars. You don't want to take that by yourself. You need Jamjack to come and help you if you're going to take that, I think. But actually, he's got a lot more coming. Maybe it's viable. Tim has 90 galleys, but there are at least 25, 30 there. So maybe Bars is 67. If they're all here, can take this fight. I don't know, but Tim is going to escape from his clutches. As Jamjack probes forward through the middle but runs into the rest of Tim. How's Remy doing on the right hand side? I thought that was a landing on Jamjack's island actually, but actually it's just going to be a bunch of Vivis getting trapped. Fast fireship approach for Jamjack in the Imperial Age then. That's interesting to see. We talked about how his galleons would lack bracer in the Imperial Age, so he's going to mix in some fast fireships. Vivi is gonna just keep applying the pressure to Remy, try and stop him gathering this stone. He's denied an extra castle on the shore. Tim's escaped into the open water. Let's just, still on Remy's point of view actually, aren't we? He's still so far away from Imp. 37 population. The Polish players have really got to do decisive damage to one of the Chinese players soon to avoid this just being 4v3 for the long term. Jamjack's getting coinage, maybe to try and sling Remy back into it. As the Polish team tries to take a big engagement against the huge fleet that Tim has at this point, and it's a really nice one, I think. It'd be even nicer if Bars was just a little bit further forward, I think, but the patrol will keep on advancing forward, and Tim's going to get out of there, but he's going to suffer so much damage, isn't he, as he tries to get out of there. He's running half, sort of half his fleet's running past Bars, and that means that Bars now has as many, if not more, galleys than... Yeah, a lot more galleys than Tim, actually. So maybe that engagement there is the route back into the game for Poland, with Bars now looking like the strongest and most fearsome player on the map. Vivi's landing on the island of Remy, looking to wipe him out. One watchtower, though, for Vivi might well do the business, keep those vills away from building the castle. They'll try and build a siege workshop there. Vivi's got the galleons behind there to try and support those villagers, but whether they'll really be able to help those villagers survive and get the buildings built, I don't know. Don't really necessarily see it. Obviously, they could take the tower down very easily though at this point. Looks like a big China push down the left-hand side though, and quite a few guys from here from the Polish team are kind of out of position. Might have been mowed down had those galleys engaged. Huge fight in the middle as well. It's looking like Tim possibly has enough to take this 1v2 here. See how it works out. Look at his kill to death ratio though. 300 to 200. Everybody else in the game is like 1 for 1 or even less. Cap Rams in the mix though. It'd be nice if they were able to get this like Cap Rams or even Seed Rams there and then just make the fight happen like here to here. That would really turn it in their favour, but look at this, the Chinese players, they're reinforcing this position so well. Really going in the favour of them, I think this one is. But Tim is well down in population, 33. Maybe not. Maybe there's more here than I thought from the Chinese, from the Polish team, I mean. I think with Vivi coming here, the Chinese team will take this fight, but it may have gone into the Polish team's favour up until that point, but really now they need to have retreated about 10 seconds ago, I think, at least. They're going to get out there and not lose all. But yeah, Bars is still on 75. And Tim is really, really down, isn't he? But Vivi is the one who's coming into his own now with 6 to 8 military, although some of that might be land-based units, I don't know. Chinese team doing a really good job of taking map control on Vivi's island, though. Taking control of some of these extra wood lines that will be denied to Vivi, to Remy, sorry. Maybe able to take a relic too. And they're also laying siege to the front of his base, as we saw, although that landing from Vivi has been denied. And Remy, with 3 castles up, will be able to kind of just do his best to reboom here. But he's got so few resources to take in terms of wood, hasn't he? Having lost access to basically half the wood on his island. At least, though, the Polish team do have access to 2 of the extra resource islands at this point. Not a terrible amount of wood on each island. There's a lot of players getting capped rams now to try and add in those meat shields. This is looking like a good fight for the Chinese team. Such a large number of galleys from 3 players, all patrolling in, getting a nice concave formation, as the ones from Baal's kind of not really all getting in the fight together and really being whittled down. I think needs to retreat from there. Jamzak's coming in from the north. I think that Baal should turn around and take this now together with Jamzak. Should he? Just momentary missteps here by the Polish team, I think, because Jamzak can't take this alone, but together they should be able to. Baal's needed to come back into the fight 10 seconds earlier. Castle's also doing a bit of work for Baal's. But yeah, Jamzak's really getting cleaned up here. And Baal's, you're right clicking, you need to patrol. This could be a really pivotal engagement in the game, depending on who's going to win it. Remy's down to 47 population and 1 military right now. He's really not having an impact in this game. I wonder if he's just slinging at this point. But yeah, the Polish team are going to take this engagement. The Chinese team will concede it and retreat, but they do have a lot of numbers in reserve. I'm just going to look. Yeah, no slinging from Remy. He's going to try and reboom, but he's even losing the castles on his island to a single treb from across the channel. Not good for him. Seems we haven't really looked at what Kimu's been doing for quite some time, but he's really struggling, isn't he? He's down to just 12 military, and he's mainly up against IMOK at this point, who's on 55 Saracen galleons, making them extra strong. It seems like, although Kimu isn't in the same poor position that he, Remy is on the opposite side for Poland, the flanks just once again collapsing a little bit for the Polish team. A lot of Kimu's economy is just idle right now. I'm not sure what all these villagers are doing. That could be a sizable amount of gold they're carrying. He won't want to lose them. Seen someone in the chat saying Jamzak doing cavalry armor. Yes, indeed, he's trying to retake the half of Remy's island with some cavalier, but they're calling GG the Polish team. Sorry for the extended silence there, I was taking a drink, but it was well timed since it was the conclusion of the game. Good job by the Chinese team there. I did think there was a moment where they were going to come back when Tim decreased his numbers for a while and Baal's was looking in terrifying shape, but I think Poland were always going to be struggling for so long once Remy really just lost out in the Castle Age. He got screwed over by the map generation here. You have to say that, but you know, he could have dealt. The Polish team could have dealt with it, and they really just needed to play a really strong yes. game on the right hand side to make up for how vulnerable Remy was. But Remy got taken out of the game. It was 3v4 from then on, and the lack of a Saracen player in the late game is always an issue as well. So 2-0 for the Chinese team. Let's see what their home map's going to be. Wouldn't be surprised if they just went Arabia, but they may go Nomad perhaps. I'll flick some music on and we'll be on to game 2, 3, not game 2, in just a minute or two.